Very good evening to all of you and welcome to India's largest e-learning platform GridUp, and welcome to my session today, Frequently Asked Questions on Token Bucket. So guys, it is one of the important topic, Token Bucket, and most of the students got confused whenever they solve the Token Bucket question. I don't know why students got confused. Okay, so today we will discuss some good questions related to the Token Bucket, and definitely by attending this class, your all concept regarding the token bucket will be clear, and you can solve each and every questions. So today we will discuss some good questions related to token bucket, guys. And it is one of the important, and there is a, in the token bucket there is only one formula. If you know the formula, so you can solve the question. Okay. Today I will discuss this formula also. I will not go so much detail, but I will, because this is the practice session, so I will discuss this formula also. And actually, after 2 or 3 days, I will take the separate class for traffic shaping concept. There is a leaky bucket and token bucket. So I will cover the entire concept also for leaky bucket and token bucket in a free app class. So it is free app class after 2 or 3 days. There is a topic already in the schedule plan. So after 2 or 3 days, I will cover the token bucket concept, and there is a one good concept, Hamming code. I will also cover after 2 or 3 days. Okay, so I will discuss the entire the leaky bucket concept as well as the token bucket concept. In that class, I will discuss the entire concept. Okay, at 5 p.m. on GridUp app. But today I will discuss the formula as well, and we will discuss some good questions of related to token bucket. So please confirm me that am I audible? Am I visible? Everything is fine, guys. Sab kuch theek hai? Am I audible? Am I visible? Everything is fine. So I will continue the session. So guys, before starting the session, I want to tell you about myself Ankit Dovila. I have 8 plus year of teaching experience. I secured All India rank 159 in GATE, All India rank 119 in NET JRF. Other than the GATE and NET, I also qualified ISRO exam, NILET exam and UPPCL exam, and my area of expertise is computer network, compiler design and theory of computation. Okay. So guys, there is a Vision 2022 batch already started from 15th Feb. So in this batch, we cover 600 plus of live classes, 5000 plus practice question, 100 plus mock test, 100 plus chapter wise study notes. For more information, you can contact on this number. Okay. So let's start. I will discuss some points before going to the questions. I want to discuss some points that you will understand the scenario here. Okay. I'm not going so much detail. I will take only 5 minutes to explain the concept, and after that we will solve some questions. So token bucket, in regular intervals, tokens are thrown into the bucket. Bucket has a maximum capacity. Yeah, every bucket has a maximum capacity. If there is a ready packet, a token is removed from the bucket and packet is sent. So what are the concept? If there is a ready packet, so we remove a one token from the bucket and we can send one packet. So this is nothing but a token bucket concept. If token bucket already have 10 tokens, so we can remove the 10 token and we can send 10 packets. If already the bucket have 100 packets, so we can delete the 100 tokens, remove the 100 tokens from the bucket, and we can send 100 packets onto the network. Next is, if there is no token in the bucket, the packet cannot be sent. So we can send a packet only if the bucket have some token. If bucket have 5 token, I can send only 5 packet. I will remove the 5 tokens from the bucket and I will send 5 packet. Okay. So now guys, actually I will take a one scenario here. Suppose this is the host computer. Suppose this is the network. So I am taking this picture as before, and I am making another picture after. What happened, I will discuss it. So join the session quickly, guys, and keep like the session and share the session. 2 also. I will not take more than 5 minutes to discuss this concept. I will take only 5 minutes, and after that we will discuss some good questions. If you understand the concept, there is no problem by solving the questions. If you don't know the concepts, always we have a problem solving the question. Now, suppose guys, this is the bucket here. This bucket have 3 tokens. This is the 1 token, this is the 2 token, this is the 3 tokens. Okay. And now guys, we have, suppose this 5 packets are ready here. This packet number 1, this packet number 2, this packet number 3, and this packet number 4, suppose, and this packet number 5. 5 packets are ready. But in the bucket, we have how many tokens, guys? 3 tokens. So we remove 1 token from the bucket and we can send 1 packet onto the network. We can remove another token from the bucket, we can send packet number 2. We can remove 1 token, we can send packet number 3. So what happened after that? This packet number 1 or packet number 2, packet number 3 will be onto the network. I will transfer this all 3 packet into the network, because I cannot send 5, because bucket have only the 3 token. If bucket have 3 token, we can send only 3 packets onto the network. So now this packet number 4 and packet number 5 are waiting here. I cannot send, because why? Because bucket does not have a token. If bucket does not have a token, we cannot send a packet. This is the concept here. No. So actually guys, how I make this generalized formula here to solve the token bucket concept, token bucket question. Let's see. Let the capacity of token bucket equal to C token. So every bucket, if there is a bucket, bucket have a capacity. So let the capacity of a token bucket equal to C token. And tokens enter into the bucket at the rate of R token per second. Because I told to you that now, in the regular interval, tokens are thrown into the bucket. So tokens are thrown into the bucket. So tokens are added to the bucket at the rate of R token per second. It means in the bucket, we are adding R token per second. Per second, how many tokens we are adding? R tokens per second. We are adding into the bucket. Okay. At the rate of R token per second. Okay. The maximum number of packets, that can be entered onto the network during the time interval t second. What they are saying, listen me carefully. If you understand this concept, you do not have any problem by solving the question. So actually guys, what they are saying is maximum number of packets that can be entered onto the network during the time interval t second. So in the t second, how many packets that can be entered onto the network? So listen me carefully guys, this is the bucket here. Okay, suppose if this bucket already we have C token, how many tokens this bucket we have already? C tokens. If C token already this bucket have, so we can remove this C token and we can send the C packet onto the network. Suppose this is the network, we can send C packet onto the network. There is no problem. I already discussed that. If there are 10 tokens in the bucket, we can send 10 packets onto the network. Okay. Tokens enter into the bucket at the rate of R token per second. Per second, how many tokens we are adding into the bucket? R token. So if per second we are adding here R token, so this is nothing but R token per second. This is nothing but R token per second. So during the time interval T, so in the T second, how many tokens we can enter into the bucket? In the 1 second, we can add R token. So in the T second, how many tokens we can add RT token. So C token already there. That's why we have sent C packet immediately. We can send C packet. And in the T second, how many tokens are added into the bucket? RT tokens. How many tokens are entered into the bucket? RT token. So we can also send RT. So in the duration of, in the time interval T second, we can send C plus RT packet. So maximum number of packets that can be entered onto the network during the time interval T second, this is nothing but, guys, C plus RT. Are you getting this point? So maximum number of packets, maximum number of packets equal to C plus RT. In the time interval T second, if we can send C plus RT packet, so how many packets you can send in 1 second? In T second, you are sending C plus RT. So in the 1 second, how many you can send? C plus RT by T. In the 1 second, how many you can send? C plus RT by T. So in the 1 second, this is nothing but C plus RT by T. So maximum number of packets, this is nothing but C plus RT. What is the maximum average rate, guys? Maximum average rate for token bucket equal to C plus RT by T. This is the maximum average rate. If you know this formula, you can solve any question of token. But we have to discuss something also regarding this formula. So now we have to apply this formula. Okay, now let's see what is the given. So maximum average rate is nothing but C plus RT by T. Now let's come to the topic. Let's come to the question. Now we will apply that here. So you will understand this case here. Consider a token bucket capacity 800 MB. How much? 800 MB. So this C is given here, 800 MB, guys. And tokens arrive at the rate of 100 MB bytes per second. Token arrival rate is nothing but the R. R is given 100 MB byte per second. Maximum output rate is 300 M byte per second. What is the worst time? Worst time is T, they are asking T. So actually what they are asking? They are asking T. So we, and I don't know the T value. So actually I know one thing, that in the time interval T, how many packet I can send? C plus RT packet I can send. What is the average rate in the 1 second? C plus RT by T. This is the maximum average rate. This is the maximum average rate. Maximum average rate I am denoting by M. Maximum average rate I am denoting by M. So this is nothing but, guys, what is this? C plus RT equal to MT. So this C equal to MT minus RT. So M minus R, if I take here T common, what is T value? T is nothing but C upon M minus R. So what is the worst time? Worst time they are asking T. So this M is maximum average rate. So maximum output rate is nothing but, what is M given here? 300 M byte per second. Okay. So what is T here? T is nothing but, what is the C? C is nothing but 800 M byte divide by. What is the m here? This is nothing but 300 m byte per second minus r value is nothing but 100 m byte. Sorry, 100 m byte per second. So this is nothing but, guys, t is nothing but 800 m byte divide by, this is nothing but 200 m byte per second. So m bytes m byte cancel, this is nothing but t equal to 4 second. Solving the question is very simple here. So guys, solving the question is very simple here, but analysis is difficult. Okay, what is analysis? Listen me carefully. What is the meaning of this t? The meaning of this t is nothing but, guys, actually in this question what r is given here? This r is given 100 m bytes per second. So we are adding the token at the rate 100 m bytes per second. But maximum output rate we are sending at this 300 m bytes per second. How we can send 300? If we are adding 100 tokens, suppose if we are adding 100 tokens per second, how we can send 300 tokens? This is the maximum average rate, maximum output rate. We are sending on this network 300 tokens due to the initial capacity. Because initially in the bucket have some tokens. So what they are saying that actually, guys, this rate, because we are sending 300 m bytes per second, this rate, through this rate we can send only for first 4 seconds I can send with this rate m, 300 m bytes per second. After this 4 second, listen me carefully, this rate 300 m bytes per, because token are added, suppose we are adding 100 tokens per second and we are sending 300 packet per second, how it is possible? If we are adding 100 tokens, so we can remove 100 token, we can send 100 packets. This is the case, no? Adding 100 token, we can send 100 packet. But what they are saying that we are sending 300 packets, but adding 100 token, it is possible because in the bucket already have some token. Because in the bucket have 800 MB, means 800 tokens already there. So this rate 300 M bytes, it can be maintained only for first 4 seconds. After the 4 second, this M, this output rate is equal to this R. Why 4 second? Because in the first 4 second, entire bucket will be empty. Listen me carefully, guys. Now, if you understand this concept, now you can solve any question. Any question you can solve here. It is very, very important here. This is the bucket. This bucket already have 800 MB data. If t equal to 4 second, in the 4 second, I am sending R this 100 MB per second. So in the 4 second, how much I will add? 400. In the 4 second, if I add this R, means 100 MB per second. Per second, I am adding 100 tokens. So in the 4 second, how many tokens I can add? 400. So how many byte I can add? 400. So this 800 bytes already here, and this 4 MB byte here. So this is nothing but 1200 M byte. So if we have 1200 M byte and we are sending at 300 M byte per second, so it means these 1200 M bytes, because we are sending at 300 M byte per second, so these 1200 MB byte data I can send in only 4 seconds. And after the 4 second, this entire bucket will be empty, because bucket already have 800 MB, and in the first 4 second we have added 400 byte. So it means it is 1200 byte, and these 1200 byte, this entire bucket will be emptied after 4 second. And after 4 second, what happened? We are adding at 100 MB per second. We are adding in the data at 100 MB per second. Kitna add kar rahe? 100 MB. If we are adding 100 MB per second, so we can send only 100 MB per second. So remember this point, that this t is nothing but what is the time, up to what time you can send with this speed. So with this speed m, 300 m byte, I can send only for first 4 second. And after first 4 second, I cannot send more this. After the first 4 second, my m will be equal to r. So this average rate will not be maintained up to a long duration of time. Sir, how? You have any proof? Huh? Mere paas proof hai bhai. It's very simple that we are getting thus, this is nothing but m equal to c plus rt by t. Okay. So guys, if I take here limit t tends to infinity c plus rt by t. If I divide the numerator and denominator by t, so this is nothing but c by t plus r and limit t tends to infinity. So what is this? This becomes 0 here plus r. So this m is nothing but equal to r. So if I find for long duration of time, this m value become r. So after the bucket will be empty, what is your output rate? At which speed you can send onto the network? Only at the r. So r is nothing but token enter into the bucket at the rate of r. So you can also send at the rate of r. You can maintain this m, this 300 m bytes only for first t second. It is clear to you? If it is clear, so you can solve any question. There is no problem by solving the questions. Clear guys? Now, can I move to next question? So this t is nothing but time taken to empty the bucket. So this t 4 second means in the 4 second the entire bucket will be empty. So this t is nothing but entire bucket will be empty after 4 second. If bucket will be empty, you are adding the tokens at the r and you can send at the rate of r. You can send at the rate of r. Now this is the question number 2 guys. This question was asked in the gate 2008. Tell me the correct answer for this question. A computer on 10 Mbps network is regulated by token bucket. Token bucket is filled at the rate of 2 Mbps. So it means R is given here 2 Mbps. It is initially filled to be capacity with 16 megabytes. So this C is given here 16 Mbits. What is the maximum duration for which the computer can transmit at full 10 Mbps? For what duration it can send at 10 Mbps? So computer on 10 Mbps network is regulated. This is M. Output is regulated 10 Mbps. So this M is 10 Mbps. What they are asking? They are asking that this rate 10 Mbps you can maintain for what duration? So this 10 Mbps you can maintain for what duration? Because you are sending at R means 2. You are adding token at 2 Mbps and you are sending at 10 Mbps. So you can send at 10 Mbps only for some time. Because due to the initial capacity, because due to initially already have some token in the bucket. So this T is nothing but C upon M minus R. C is 16 Mbits. What is M? M is 10 Mbits. Mbits per second. Minus. This is nothing but 2 Mbits per second. So this is nothing but 16 Mbits divided by 8 Mbits per second. So this is the cancel here. This answer will be nothing but the 2 second. Why? So you can maintain this rate 10 Mbps only for first 2 second. After the 2 second, you cannot maintain this rate. Sir, why? Guys, because this is the bucket here, this bucket already have 16 Mbits, no? In the 2 second, you can add how many? Because you are adding at 2 Mbps. So in the 2 second, you can add 4 Mbits. So this bucket have 20 Mbits, and we are sending at 10 Mbits per second. So this 20 Mbits you can send in 2 seconds, no? So first 2 seconds, this entire bucket will be empty. After this, you can send with the rate of R only. You can send only 2 Mbits per second. After this, you can send only 2 Mbits per second. The correct answer for this question is B, 2 seconds. It is clear to everyone, guys? ये बात समझ में आ गई आपको? आगे बढ़ जाएं. स्टूडेंट की प्रॉब्लम क्या है? क्वेश्चन सॉल्व करने हैं बट कंसेप्ट नहीं सीखा. बस क्वेश्चन सॉल्व हो जाए एकदम बस, लेकिन कंसेप्ट समझ में आया नहीं है. जब कंसेप्ट समझ आते हैं तो आप ध्यान से पढ़ते नहीं हो, आपको बस क्वेश्चन करना है. अरे क्वेश्चन भी तो तभी होगा जब कंसेप्ट क्लियर है. ये फार्मूला याद करने से कुछ नहीं होगा. फार्मूला बनाया कैसे, क्या लॉजिक अप्लाई हो रहा है, वो आपको आना चाहिए. तभी आप क्या कर सकते हो, सॉल्व कर सकते हो. चलो कम्स टू द नेक्स्ट ईयर, क्वेश्चन नंबर 3. यही तो है यूट्यूब में, यही तो चल रहा है यूट्यूब में. स्टूडेंट सोचता है बस क्वेश्चन मिल जाए, बस ऐसे क्वेश्चन मिल जाए जो आसानी से होते रहे सॉल्व, बस मैं फटाफट से फार्मूला लगाऊं और आंसर आ जाए और बस मैं खुश हो जाऊंगा कि यार मेरा तो सारे क्वेश्चन बन रहे हैं. ठीक है, क्वेश्चन ऐसे थोड़ी बनते हैं. क्वेश्चन तभी बनेंगे, पहले आपको कंसेप्ट पढ़ना है, और कंसेप्ट पढ़ने के लिए समय लगता है. और आज की दुनिया में समय है नहीं बच्चों के पास. जब समय नहीं है तो भाई, तो ऐसी हाल है, रिजल्ट भी ऐसा ही आ रहा है बच्चों का आजकल. ये प्रॉब्लम है. Now what the answer for this guys? यही तो बात है. फिर बोलते हैं सर रिजल्ट नहीं आया, बहुत मेहनत करी पूरे साल, दुनिया भर के YouTube के लेक्चर सुने बट लेकिन रिजल्ट नहीं आया, क्वालिफाई हो नहीं हुआ सर. अरे भाई पहले कंसेप्ट तो पढ़ लो, तभी तो होगा कुछ. और आज की डेट में तो इतनी सारी आपको हेल्प मिल रही है, ये बहुत अच्छी बात है. और पहले क्या होता था, आपके पास कोई सोर्स नहीं था. ऐसा नहीं था यूट्यूब कोई सोर्स नहीं था. जब हम लोग तैयारी करते थे यूट्यूब का तो मतलब कुछ सोचो ही मत उस समय. नेट इतना महंगा था, यूट्यूब तो कोई खोलने का सोच भी नहीं सकता था. क्या सोर्स था, सिर्फ किताबें सोर्स थी. किताब पढ़ के समझ में आ गया अच्छी बात है, नहीं आया तो कोई हेल्प करने के लिए भी नहीं है. अब तो आपको इतने सारे सोर्स मिल रहे हैं. कंप्यूटर ऑन 6 Mbps नेटवर्क इज रेगुलेटेड by a token bucket. The token bucket is filled at the rate of 1 Mbps. So R is given here 1 Mbps. Initially filled capacity with 8 megabits. C is given here 8 megabits. Mbits. So this M, how long can a computer transmit at full 6 Mbps? So this is also asking P value. 6 Mbps. This M is this 6 Mbps. So actually this is simple that up to what time you can maintain this rate, this is asking, because R value is 1. We are adding token at 1 Mbps, 1 Mbits per second. So suppose we are adding 1 M tokens per second and we are sending 6 M token, 6 M packet, how it is possible? Due to the initial capacity. So this T is nothing but C upon M minus R. So this C is nothing but 8 Mbits divided by, what is M here? 6 Mbps minus 1 Mbps. So this is nothing but 8 Mbits divided by 5 Mbits per second. 1.6 second. Clear hai baat? So the correct answer for this question is, guys, 1.6 second. हाँ मुझे पता है ना सेशन चले गए. स्टार्टिंग में जो मैं कंसेप्ट डिस्कस कर रहा था वो कंसेप्ट सीखना ही नहीं किसी को. और मुझे पता है जितने आए थे ना यूट्यूब पे आज के लेक्चर को लेने के लिए किसी को कंसेप्ट नहीं आता, वो किसी को नहीं आता मुझे पता है. हालत खराब हो जाएगी पूछ लिए एक क्वेश्चन तो. हालत खराब हो जाएगी, कंसेप्ट नहीं आता, फार्मूला रट रखा है, फार्मूला आया कहां से, कैसे अप्लाई करना है कुछ नहीं पता, बस फॉर्मूला रख लिया बस. अरे सर ये तो फॉर्मूला हमें पता है. आप क्या बता रहे हो, मुझे पता है ना कि यूट्यूब पर किसी ने बता ही नहीं रखा है, सर्च कर लो आप अच्छे से, किसी ने नहीं बता रखा जो मैंने बताया आपको. ये टी क्या आ रहा है हमारे पास, नाउ दिस इज द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन गाइस. इमेजिन द मैक्सिमम पैकेट साइज इज 1000 बाइट, ओके. द टोकन बकेट रेट इज 10 मिलियन बाइट पर सेकेंड, टोकन बकेट साइज इज 1 मिलियन बाइट, मैक्सिमम ट्रांसमिशन रेट इज 50 मिलियन बाइट पर सेकेंड, हाउ लॉन्ग ए बस्ट कैन मैक्सिमम स्पीड लास्ट. व्हाट द आंसर फॉर दिस क्वेश्चन. बकेट रेट इज 10 मिलियन बाइट पर सेकेंड, सो इट मीन्स दिस आर इज गिवन हियर एम बाइट पर सेकेंड. टोकन बकेट साइज इज 1 मिलियन बाइट, सी इज नथिंग बट 1 एम बाइट. मैक्सिमम ट्रांसमिशन रेट 50 मिलियन, सो दिस एम इज नथिंग बट 50 मिलियन बाइट पर सेकेंड. हाउ लॉन्ग ए बस्ट at maximum speed, again they are asking t here, so there is no meaning that this is given here, this is given only for confusion. Mayur, grade up pe particular subject purchase karna nahi, grade up pe particular subject purchase karna to possible nahi hai, but subscription hai sir, 3 month, 6 month, 1 year, so 3 mahine ka aap subscription le sakte hain, maan lo aapko 2 ya 3 subject padhne. और मयूर आप जीएनएसटी भी दे दो, ग्रेड अप स्कॉलरशिप टेस्ट के थ्रू आपकी फीस बहुत कम भी हो जाएगी. सी अपॉन एम माइनस आर डिवाइड बाई पर सेकेंड माइनस 10 एम बाइट पर सेकेंड. पचास माइनस ये कितना हो गया 40, 1/40 0.025 आएगा ना सेकेंड, बट आंसर इज गिवन इन मिली सेकेंड, सो मिली सेकेंड मीन्स मल्टीप्लाई बाई 10^3. पच्चीस मिली सेकेंड दी आंसर फॉर दिस क्वेश्चन. जीएनएसटी हो चुका है और अब भी शायद होने वाला है, ठीक है, एक बार आप सर्च कर लो आपको पता चल जाएगा. गेट अप स्कॉलरशिप टेस्ट, ओके. आपको एक नंबर मैं देता हूं तो आप इस नंबर पे कॉल करके पूछ लो, ये सब आपको बता देंगे, ठीक है. सो नोट डाउन दिस नंबर 9650529049650, ओके, बिकॉज आई डोंट नॉट हैव एनी आइडिया. तो ये आप यहां से ये नंबर लिख लो और इस नंबर से पता चल जाएगा 9650529049650529049. यू कैन कॉल इन दिस नंबर, ओके. चलो देखो ये क्वेश्चन है, अच्छा दिस इज द वेरी गुड क्वेश्चन आस्क्ड इन द गेट, ओके. दिस क्वेश्चन वाज आस्क्ड इन द गेट 2016 एंड आई एम टेकिंग दिस रेफरेंस बिकॉज इट इज वेरी गुड क्वेश्चन, इट इज वेरी गुड क्वेश्चन बेस्ड ऑन द टोकन बकेट कॉन्सेप्ट, ओके. रीड दिस क्वेश्चन केयरफुली, रीड दिस क्वेश्चन केयरफुली. व्हाट एवर आई डिस्कस इन द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन सेम कॉन्सेप्ट विल बी अप्लाइड हियर इफ यू अंडरस्टैंड द एंटायर कॉन्सेप्ट व्हिच आई डिस्कस अर्लियर. So you can solve this question. Read this question. For a host machine that uses a token bucket algorithm for congestion control, the token bucket has a capacity of 1 megabyte. So this m value is given here, 1 m byte. Sorry, capacity C is given here. So this C value is given here, guys. I got only 24 marks in GATE 2021. Should I repeat or should I look for other option? Raj Patil, first of all, you analyze that where you have done mistake. Okay, your subject's concepts was not cleared, or that you have studied the entire syllabus, or you have left some subject. So what is the reason? You have to analyze that. That you have studied each and entire thing and you are not getting where you are doing mistake. उसके बेस पे यदि आपने सब कुछ पढ़ा है और कोई मिस्टेक आपको लगता नहीं है, नहीं हुई है, ऐसा हो नहीं सकता. तो मुझे लगता है कि मतलब जो भी कमियां हैं वो आप दूर करो और फिर से एक बार लग जाओ तैयारी में. ठीक है, गेट कोई डिफिकल्ट एग्जाम नहीं है, बस थोड़ा सा आपको हार्ड वर्क मांगता है. आपको बहुत अच्छे से मेहनत करनी है 6 महीने के लिए, 6 मंथ यू हैव टू डू लॉट्स ऑफ हार्ड वर्क. Then only you can secure a good rank. And also that it's also depend actually. Sometimes we are following someone and we have studied the entire subject and later we realize that what we have studied is not for GATE level. We have studied the full subject and we have waste our time approximate 100 hours or 90 hours or 60 hours. And later we think that what we studied, we are not able to solve the previous year question as well. If after finishing the entire subject, if you are not able to solve 80% GATE question, it means your concepts are not clear. Or kabhi kabhi after 1 year we realize that we studied all subject but not up to the GATE level. So it's maybe a chance that you have studied entire thing but not up to the GATE level. तो एक साल के बाद कभी कभी मैं realize होता है हमने जो पढ़ा गलत पढ़ लिया, कहीं और से पढ़ना चाहिए. Now maximum output rate is 20 megabyte per second. This M is given here, 20 megabyte. Token arrive rate at this 10 megabyte per second. This R is given 10 megabyte per second. So why is this C is given, M is given, R is given? We can find T. What we are seeing that the token bucket is currently full and machine need to send 12 megabyte of data. The minimum time required to transmit the data in the second. So actually we can find T here. How we can find T? T is nothing but C upon M minus R. What is C? C is nothing but 1 MB divided by. What is the M? M is nothing but 20 M byte per second. Minus 10 m byte per second. So this is nothing but guys 1 by 10. This is nothing but 0.1 second. What is the meaning of I was blank. अरे ऐसा कैसे हो? तो आपने मेहनत करी है तो फिर राज पटेल कुछ ना कुछ गड़बड़ हो गई है, तो टेंशन मत लो, आप अगले साल से तैयारी करो. ठीक है, फिर से तैयारी करो. ठीक है, ऐसा एक स्टूडेंट के साथ और हुआ है, उसके 29-30 मार्क्स आ रहे हैं और उसने मेहनत की थी, तो कोई बात नहीं है. कभी कभी ऐसा हो जाता है, दिमाग आपने काम नहीं किया है उधर पेपर में, तो आप दोबारा से एक बार एफर्ट दो 100%. ठीक है, now
So actually this, what is the 0.1? This 0.1 is nothing but you can send with this speed m. This m you can maintain only for first 0.1 second, and this 0.1 second is nothing but time taken to empty the bucket. So first 0.1 second you can send with this speed, and after the 0.1 you can send only with this speed. So guys, in the 0.1 second, first 0.1 second we can send with 20 m byte per second. So if we send 20 m bytes per second in the first 0.1 second, so this is nothing but 20 0.1 into 20. सेकेंड टू सेकेंड कैंसिल, तो ये कितना हो गया मेरे पास 2 MB. सो फर्स्ट 0.1 सेकेंड रैंक 525 एनी आईआईटी कॉल फॉर इंटरव्यू. हाँ, यू विल गेट डेफिनेटली कॉल, और आपको आईआईटी बॉम्बे से भी कॉल आ सकती है इंटरव्यू के लिए. आपको वहां देखिए रिटन टेस्ट देना पड़ेगा, और बाकी आपका मतलब यदि आईएससी बैंगलोर, आईआईटी बॉम्बे, आईआईटी दिल्ली, तीन को छोड़ दिया जाए, बाकी किसी भी आईआईटी में आपका हो जाएगा. गुड आईआईटी चांसेस हैं पूरे पूरे. नाउ एक्चुअली गाइस, फर्स्ट 0.1 सेकंड वी कैन सेंड विद दिस स्पीड. आफ्टर 0.1 सेकंड, सो एक्चुअली व्हाट इज माय डेटा हियर? डेटा इज 12 MB. सो डेटा साइज दिस इज नथिंग बट 12 MB. So we have sent 2 MB byte data in first 0.1 second. So what are the remaining data here? Data is nothing but 12 MB byte minus 2 MB byte, 10 MB byte. And this 10 MB byte data we can send at the rate of R. So after the 0.1 second, we can send at the rate of 10 MB byte per second. That is R. So after the first 0.1 second guys, we can send at the rate of R only. So after this T, we can send at the rate of R. What is the R here? 10 MB per second. What is our data? Our data is 10 MB data. So 10 MB data we can send in 10 seconds. So 1 second. So 10 MB data we can send only in 1 second. So what is the total time guys? So this first 2 MB we can send in the 0.1 second, and remaining 10 MB I can send in the 1. So this is nothing but 1.1 second is the answer. 1.1 second is the answer. Get the good question. No more question like this. Okay, we will discuss soon. So whenever we cover this topic in the free app class, Varuna, after 2 or 3 days, so we will discuss more questions. Okay, today I have included only these 5. Okay, so I hope you understand the point guys. You got this enough point here. So this is the case that this is the good question. This type of question they can ask. So whatever the T you are getting, this T is nothing but time taken to empty the bucket. So this T means 0.1 second.
So first 0.1 second you can send with the speed of m, whatever the m is given, and remaining data you can send with the speed of r. This same things I explained earlier. Okay, got it? Okay, so thank you guys. These are all our star faculties. And guys, weekend batch already started from 9th March, and the vision batch already started from 13th March. और free app classes भी going on है सारी faculties की, तो आप यहाँ से free app classes भी join कर सकते हो. These are the great up achievers of All India rank under 100 from computer science. Great up super means structured live course and green card. So आपको एक पूरा structured में एक course मिलेगा और उसके साथ साथ ग्रीन कार्ड भी मिलेगा. ग्रीन कार्ड मींस जिससे कि आप टेस्ट सीरीज दे सकते हो. ठीक है, सो व्हाट दी बेनिफिट फॉर गेटअप सुपर? अनलिमिटेड एक्सेस टू ऑल स्ट्रक्चर लाइव कोर्स एंड मॉक टेस्ट. स्ट्रक्चर लाइव कोर्स, फुल कवरेज ऑफ सिलेबस, कंप्लीट डाउट रिजोल्यूशन, एक्सपर्ट फैकल्टीज एंड परफॉर्मेंस एंड रिपोर्ट कार्ड यू ऑल्सो गेट. सो गाइस, यदि आप सही प्रेफ है तो लाइफ सेट है. यदि सही आपने प्रिपरेशन की है तो आपकी लाइफ सेट है गाइस. और यदि आपने ग्रेडअप का ऐप अभी तक प्ले स्टोर से डाउनलोड नहीं किया है तो आप ग्रेडअप का ऐप भी डाउनलोड कर सकते हो प्ले स्टोर से, और फ्री क्लासेस का आप आनंद उठा सकते हो ग्रेडअप ऐप पर. ठीक है, सो थैंक यू गाइस, बाय बाय. आई विल सी यू टुमारो सेम टाइम. थैंक यू, बाय बाय.